great day, and you're a great couple, and I'm sure everybody here will attest to that. And even though I was, I was very young when they got married. Very, very young. I still kind of remember part of it. So we tried to recreate the part of your wedding that we can remember. So without further ado, let the wedding ceremony begin.
To unite this horny young man, Carl Elding Peterson, and this beautiful young woman, Helen Teresa McGaugh, in the bonds of holy matrimony, which is an honorable estate. Into this, these two now come to be joined. Before we continue, we must poll the audience first to find out whether or not they expect this marriage to last, or if we should stop at this time. All those in favor, please shout, yay.
Yay!
Those who are not so certain, shout nay.
Nay.
It appears that we shall continue. Next. All former girlfriends, hookers, and hooter babes, please bring Charlie's old apartment keys to the front and deposit them in the box on the table. The altar of Helen's virginity, as this time is also passed. We are all in the fervent hope that no fraternity suits will follow.
This is it.
If anyone present can show just and legal cause why they may not be joined, and let them speak now or forever hold their peace. Who gives this woman to this man?
I do. I am extremely glad someone is willing to take her, and this is a permanent situation. She cannot be returned for any reason.
Thank you. Well, you have this woman as your lawful wedded wife. To live together in a state of utter misery and chaos, ignoring all her wants and wishes, paying attention only to your own whims, fervently bestowing repeated demonstrations of your virility so as to beget and perpetuate your name as selflessly as you like. Will you love her, honor her, comfort her, and keep her satisfied in sickness and in health, forsaking all others? Be true to her as long as you both shall live.
I suppose.
Helen, will you have this man as your lawful wedded husband?
Yeah, yeah.
To live together in a state of total submission, doing all cooking, cleaning, childbearing, and either menial, disgusting chores, other menial, disgusting chores as befitting all married women, without complaint, with no expectation of rewards or kindness.
I suppose.
This is my time.
Term of captivity, the unbroken union of this man and this woman united here today. Please join hands and repeat after me. I, Charles, take thee, Helen, as my wedded toy.
I, Charles, take thee, Helen, as my wedded toy. To dominate from this day forward,
for worse or for worser,
for worse or for worser,
for richer or for poorer,
for richer or for poorer, in sickness and in health,
to love and to cherish till death do us part,
to love and to cherish till death do us part.
I, Helen.
Take Charles as my wedded plaything.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
To have and to hold from this day forward.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For poor or for poorer.
For poor or for poorer.
In sickness and in health.
Sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
Love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Forasmuch as Charles and Helen have consented to live together in wedlock and have witnessed the same before this company of friends and family, and have given and pledged their promises to each other, and have declared the same by giving and receiving ring and by joining hands, by the authority vested in me by total insanity, I pronounce this couple to be husband and wife.
This year's you've been married and we all
could get some music.
Very good.